Good morning, children. Hope you all are safe at home. Welcome to the math class. Let us check the key answers for the exercise 2.2. The first question, find the sum by suitable rearrangement. First one has been discussed before, so let us move towards the second one. That is to add 1962 plus 453 plus 1538 plus 647. So here also I am going to rearrange the numbers so that my addition will become easier. So in the next step, I am going to group the numbers 1962 plus 1538, and then again I am going to group the numbers 453 and 647. So in the next step, when I add these two numbers, I'll get 3500, whereas when I add these two numbers, I'll get 1100. So in the next step, I can add them very easily, right? When I add these two numbers, I'll get 4600, which is the final sum. Second question, find a product by suitable rearrangement. So first one has been discussed before, so let us move towards the second one. That is 4 into 166 into 25. Here I am going to multiply this 4 and 25 first. After that I am going to multiply by 166. That is in the next step, when I multiply 4 and 25, I'll get 100 into 166. So 1 into 166 is 166 followed by two zeros. So my final answer is 16,600. So next sum, 8 into 291 into 125. So here also I am going to multiply this 8 and 125 first, so that I'll get 1000. To that 1000 I'm going to multiply 291. That is 1 into 291 is 291 followed by 3 zeros. So my final answer is 291,000. Next problem, 625 into 279 into 16. So here also I'm going to multiply 625 and 16 first, so that I'll get 10,000. To that I'm going to multiply 279. That is 1 into 279 is 279 followed by 4 zeros. So my final answer is 27,90,000. The next problem, 285 into 5 into 16. Here also I am going to keep this 285 as it is, where I am going to multiply this 5 and 60 first, so that I will get 300. Now I will multiply 285 into 3, that is 855 followed by 2 zeros. So my final answer is 85,500. The next problem, 125 into 40 into 8 into 25. Here I am going to multiply this 125 and 8, so that I will get 1000. Next I am going to multiply 40 into 25, I will get 1000. So then in the next step I am going to multiply this 1000 into 1000. So my final answer will be 10 lakhs. Now let us continue with the next question, that is to find the value of the following. Observe the first one. 297 into 17 plus 297 into 3. Here I am going to group the numbers. That is, the first group will have 297 into 17. The second group will have 297 into 3. If you observe, in both the groups, 297 into is common, right? So in the next step, I have taken 297 into common. Then what is left over? That is 17 plus 3 is left over. I'll take them together. So in the next step, 297 as it is, 297 into as it is, 17 plus 3 is 20. Is it not? So I am going to multiply these two numbers to get the final answer. That is 5940. So 5940 is my final answer. Observe the second one now. That is, we have the numbers 54,279 into 92 plus 8 into 54,279. Here also I am going to group the numbers. If you observe, you can make out that 54,279 is common in both the cases, right? So in the next step, I will take away 54,279 into common. So what is left over? 92 plus 8 is left over. Is it not? So I have taken them together. So in the next step, 54,279 into 92 plus 8 is 100. So in the next step, 54,279 into 1 is 54,279 followed by 2 zeros. So my final answer is 54,27,900. The next problem, that is 81,265 into 169 minus 81,265 into 69. Here also, I'll make the grouping. You can make out that 81,265 is common in both the cases, right? So I am going to take out 81,265 into, then what is left over? 169 minus 69. I'll take them within the brackets. So the next step, 81,265 into 169 minus 69 is 100. So the next step, 81,265 into 1 is 81,265 followed by 2 zeros. So my final answer is 81,26,500. Okay. The next problem, that is 3,845 into 5 into 782 plus 769 into 25 into 280. Here, so we don't have any numbers in common, right? So in the next step, what I did, I have multiplied 3,845 into 5 so that I'll get 19,225. Then into as it is, 782 as it is, plus as it is. Now I'm going to multiply these two numbers, that is 769 into 25. I'll get 19,225 into 218 as it is. Now I'll group the numbers. So which is common here? So 19,225 is common in both the cases, right? So in the next step, I'll take this common number out, that is 19,225 into, so what is left over? 782 plus 218, is it not? So I'll put them within the bracket. The next step, 19,225 into 782 plus 218, that is 1000, is it not? So in the next step, 19,225 into 1 is 19,225 followed by 3 zeros. So my final answer is 1,92,25,000. Okay. The next question, find the product using suitable property. That is the first problem, 738 into 103. So we can apply the distributive property here. That is in the next step, 738 into as it is, where I'm going to expand the second number, 103 into 100 plus 3. So the next step, 738 into 100 plus 738 into 3. So the next step, 738 into 100 is how much? 73,800. That is 73,800 plus 738 into 3 is 2,214. So the next step, if I add these two numbers, I'll get 76,014. 76,014. So the second sum, 854 into 102. Here also, 854 into, I'll keep it as it is. I am going to expand the second number, that is 102. It becomes 100 plus 2. So in the next step, I am going to multiply this 854 into 100 plus 854 into 2. Is it not? So in the next step, 854 into 100 is 85,400 plus 854 into 2 is 1,708. So in the next step, if I add these two numbers, I'll get 87,108. Consider the next example, that is 258 into 1,008. Here also, 258 into, I'll keep it as it is, where I'm going to expand the 1,008. That is, I'll expand the 1,008 to 1,000 plus 8. So in the next step, 258 into 1,000 plus 258 into 8, that is 258 into 1000 plus 258 into 8. So in the next step, I'll get 258,000 plus 2064. When I add these two numbers, my final answer will be 260,064. So the next problem, 1005 into 168. I can also write them as 168 into 1005. I'll keep this 168 into as it is, where I'll expand this 1005 so that I'll get 1000 plus 5. In the next step, 168 into 1000 plus 168 into 5. So the next step, I'll get how much? Yes. When I multiply 168 into 1000, I'll get 168,000 plus 840. When I add these two numbers, my final answer will be 168,840. Next question. A taxi driver filled his car petrol tank with 40 liters of petrol on Monday. The next day, he filled the tank with 50 liters of petrol. If the petrol cost rupees 44 per liter, how much did he spend in all on petrol? So, solution. He filled 40 liters of petrol on Monday. Is it not? And he has filled 50 liters of petrol on Tuesday. So, totally 90 liters of petrol he has filled, right? So, cost of petrol is rupees 44 per liter, right? So, we can apply the distributive property here, that is rupees 44 into 40 plus 50 liters. So, I have applied the distributive property here. So, in the next step, rupees 44 into 40 plus 50 liters, that is 90 liters. When you multiply these two numbers, that is 44 into 90, your answer will be 3960. That means he has spent 3960 rupees on petrol. Children, let us consider one more problem of the same type. A vendor supplies 32 liters of milk to a hotel in the morning and 68 liters of milk in the evening. If the milk costs rupees 45 per liter, how much money is due to the vendor per day? That is, vendor supplies 32 liters of milk in the morning and 68 liters of milk in the evening, totally 100 liters, okay? Cost of milk is rupees 45 per liter. So, here also we can apply the distributive property. So, that is rupees 45 into 32 plus 68 liters. So, in the next step, rupees 45 into 100 liters. So, that is in the next step, when we multiply 45 and 100, we will get 4500. So, per day, so we will have the milk will cost rupees 4500. Children, till now we have solved the exercise 2.2. Write the questions 3rd, 4th, 5th and 6th in the homework book. Okay, thank you.